In this video, I will show you how to use the handbrake to compress large files into a smaller size file. I will also show you how to use the handbrake to convert videos into different file formats. To download handbrake, go to this link. And then click on Downloads. On the next page, select the supported version for your OS. Since I am using Windows 11, I will be downloading this version. After downloading, install the software. After installing, open Handbrake. Before proceeding with encoding, we have to make a few changes. To do that, go to Preferences. To change the theme, click on the drop-down button beside Theme. Now select a theme according to your preference. To add or change the preview player, you need the .exe path of a music player. For that, go to Windows Search. Now search for the music player that you have installed. Next, right-click on the player and select the option Open File Location. Next, copy the path. Now, click on Browse, which is next to the path in Handbrake. Now paste the path that you copied and select the music player. To set the default output path, go to Output Files. Click on Browse, which is next to the default path. Next, set the path where you want to save your encoded file. To set the file name to a specific format, leave a space after source title, which is next to file format. Now drag and drop the option from the list that you need in your file name. To enable hardware support, go to the video section. Now enable all the options that are available to you. Since I have an NVIDIA card, I am enabling these two options. For advanced settings, go to the Advanced tab. Now make all the changes that are highlighted inside the green box. If you want to reset the changes that you made to the handbrake, go to Reset. Now use this reset button if you want to reset all the user settings to default. And use this reset button to reset only the changes made to the built-in presets. After making all the changes in the preference window, restart the software. In this example, I will show you how to convert a .mov file into .mp4 file. Now drag and drop a .mov video file into Handbrake. Next, select any preset which suits your requirement. Next, select any one of the format. Next, click on Start Encode. Here is the encoded .mp4 file which we have encoded from .mov file. In the first method, I will show how to reduce file size just by changing one setting. For this example, I will be using a 1.6 GB video file. Now drag and drop the video into Handbrake. Now select a 720p resolution preset that is below the original video resolution. This is the only changes we will make to the video. Now, to keep all the other settings the same, we need to adjust the FPS and audio setting. To adjust the FPS, go to Video. Now change the frame rate to same as source. To adjust the audio setting, go to the audio. Now adjust the bit rate, mix down and sample rate to match the original video. In my case, the bit rate is 256, the mix down is stereo and the sample rate is 48. Now make all the changes. After making the changes, click on Start Encode. So here is the final result. The original 1.6 GB video is reduced to 200 MB video. Here is the quality comparison of both original and encoded video. In the second method, we will keep the resolution and the FPS similar to the original video, but tweak all the other settings. For this video, I will be using a 4.6GB video with a resolution of 1920x1080 and 60fps. Now drag and drop the video into Handbrake. Now select a preset that matches your original video resolution. Next, go to the video. Now, if you have enabled hardware support under Preferences, select the encoder based on your hardware. Since I am using an NVIDIA card, I will be choosing H.264 NVENC, which is a more widely accepted encoder. Next, change the frame rate to the same as source. Next, change the encoder preset to slow. Next, change the constant quality to 24. Next, go to audio. Now change the bitrate to 160 and mix down to stereo. After making all the changes, click on Start Encode. So here is the final result. The original 4.6GB video is reduced to 1.5GB video. Here is the quality comparison of both the original and the encoded video.
Maximilian is gone. No one knows where he is. He left the order, he left me, with these children. Born with the ability to use rift magic, Egan had no idea how powerful he was.
To add to queue, first add multiple videos. Next, select a video from the drop-down that is next to title. Next, adjust all the settings that you need. Next, click on Add to Queue. Now do this process for all the videos. Now to view the queue, click on Queue. Once everything is done, click on Start Encode. To add a new preset, first add a video to Handbrake. Next, select a preset from the drop-down. Now make all the adjustments that you need. Next, click on Save New Preset. Now enter a name for your preset. Next, create a category. Next, click on Save. Now to view or select the preset you created, you can click on the drop-down next to Preset. To edit a preset, first select a preset that has to be edited. Next, go to Presets and select the option Edit Preset. Now make the necessary edits. Next, click Save to make the changes. First, select a preset that has to be deleted. Now go to Presets and select the option Delete Preset. After adding a video, make all the changes that you need. Now let's say you want to preview the changes. For that, you need to go to Preview. Now set the preview duration. Next, click on Encode Preview. Once the encoding is done, click Play.
I'll tell you I knew that, but I didn't.
You are correct, Kelsey. That rift is different.
To upscale a video, first add a video. For this example, I am using a 1920x1080 resolution video. Next, go to Dimensions. Now, under Resolution and Scaling. Set the resolution limit as per your requirements. Next, enable the option Allow Upscaling. Next, click Start Encode. So here is the final result of the upscaled video. For downscaling, set the resolution limit below the original video. For example, if you have a 1920 by 1080p resolution video, then you can set the limit to 720p. Next, uncheck the option Allow Upscaling. Next, click on Start Encode. So here is the final result of a downscaled video. To flip a video horizontally, go to Dimensions. Now under Orientation and Cropping, enable the option Flip and then encode your video. So here is the final result. To rotate a video, go to Dimensions. Now under Orientation and Cropping, select the rotation angle using the drop-down that is next to rotation. Next, encode your video. So here is the result of the rotated video. To crop a video, go to Dimensions. Now under Orientation and Cropping, set cropping to custom. Next, enter your cropping value. Next, encode your video. So here is the result of the cropped video. To add borders to video, go to Dimensions. Now under Borders, set Fill to Custom. Next, enter the border values. Next, select the color for your borders. You can either select the default color, black or white, or you can set your own color by choosing the option Custom. Now while entering the color value, first enter 0 and then enter small case x. Next, enter your color code. After doing everything, encode your video. So here is the final result. To make the video black and white, go to Filters. Now enable the option Grayscale. Next, encode your video. So here is the final result.